Hi viewers, today I am going to explain one important topic, that is from 10th standard. Okay, 10th standard from first chapter of rational numbers, and the topic name is an irrational number without doing actual division. Whether we can say a rational number which is in the form of p by 2 gives a terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal, we have to learn about that. For example, you see one example I'm taking, that is 16 by 125. Okay, you see it is in the form of p by 2, where p is 16 and q is 125. That means 16 is numerator and denominator is 125. Yes, we can explain or we can say that this p by q form or a rational number can give which type of decimal. That means whether it gives a terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal by observing denominator only, by seeing the denominator only without doing actual division. I am not going to do the current method, that means division. I am not going to do the division, actual division. Okay, the 16 by 125, then also I can say, or everyone can say, whether this number, this p by q form, can gives a terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal. How can we say? Just once you listen careful to here, everyone. Here 125 is a denominator. Of course, any denominator. First we have to simplify this fractional number. You see here 16 and 125 has no any common factors. That's why it is in its simplest form. And then the next step, we have to write the denominator in its powers of prime factorization. Already we know that how we can find a number's powers of prime factorization. For example, once you have to take 125 and first prime factors we have to find. This 125 is not divisible by 2 table and 3 table and then 5 table. 5 table, it is divisible by 5 table. Just you have to take only prime numbers. Okay, it is divisible by 5 table. That's why 5, 2 jar 10 and 25, 5, 5 jar, next to 5 table, 5, 5 jar 25 and next to 5 table, 5 under 5. So 5 into 5 into 5. That is 125 is equal to, the prime factorization is 5 into 5 into 5. But the prime, that means the powers of prime factorization is 5 to the power of 3. That 5 to the power of 3 we should write in the denominator. 5 to the power of 3. Okay, not only this 125, you take the denominator which is given. First you have to change the denominator into powers of prime factorization and then write in the denominator. This is the second step. First step is simplification method, that means simplify the fractional number. And then the second step is denominator. You should take the denominator and write its powers of prime factorization, that is 5 to the power of 3. And the next step, we have to observe this denominator. The denominator is 5 to the power of 3. Okay? If the denominator is in the form of 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m, it is very, very important. If the denominator is in the form of 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m only, that means the denominator has only the prime factors 2 and 5. There is no other prime factors like 3, 7 or 13 or 11. Then we can say the fractional number, the given fractional number gives terminating number, that means terminating decimal. Okay, listen again. In take the denominator after powers of prime factorization of the denominator, then the denominator is in the form of 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m, where n, comma, m are belongs to nt. That means natural numbers. Natural numbers are positive integers. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Okay? So here you see this denominator is in the form of this one, where n is equal to 0. 2 to the power of 0 is 1 only, and 5 to the power of 3. So this denominator is in this form, 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m. That is, there is only 2 and 3 are the factors of the denominator. There is no other factors, other prime factors. That's why it gives terminating decimal. Terminating decimal. That's it. Very simple. We need not to do that division, actual division. To say a fractional number gives a terminating or non-terminating decimal. Okay, next. Let us take one more example, that 25 by 24. 25 by 24. The first step, we have to observe whether it is in its simplest form or not. Actually, it is in simplest form only. And now, this 25 numerator, 25 write as it is. The denominator 24, write in its powers of prime factors, 24. Okay, 2 12 ja, 2 6 ja, 2 3 ja, 3 1 ja. You see here, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. 24 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Powers of prime factorization is 2 to the power of 3, 2 to the power of 3, and 3 to the power of into 3 to the power of 1. Okay, then the third step, we have to observe the denominator. Is in the form of this one or not? We can observe that clearly. We can observe that 2 to the power of 3 into 3 to the power of 1 is not in the form of 2 to the power of m into 5 to the power of m. There is other than 2 and 5 as the prime factor. That's why it gives non-terminating repeating decimal. Okay, therefore it gives non-terminating repeating decimal. That's it. And I'm going to take one more example, that is 100 by 81. 100 by 81. It is equal to 100. We know it's 81. 81 is equal to 9 9 81. 1 9 is equal to 3 to the power of 2. Another 9 is equal to 3 to the power of 2. That means totally 81 we can write as 3 to the power of 4. You see the denominator, we can observe that the denominator is not in the form of 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m. That is why we can say this one is this answer. That means it gives non-terminating repeating decimal because of the denominator is not in the form of 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m. That's it, very simple. Okay, let us take one more example, 23 by 2 to the power of 3, 5 to the power of 2. Okay, clearly the denominator is given in the form of powers of prime factors. That's why the prime factors are 2 and 5 only. We need not to find again anything of the denominator. Directly we can say this fractional number gives terminating decimal. Terminating decimal. That means this is the answer. Okay? I'm taking one more example, the fifth example, that is 143 divided by 110. Okay, what is the first step? We have to simplify the fractional number. First, we have to observe whether it's the simplest form or not. Once you see 143 is divisible by 11 table. 110 also divisible by 11 table. So 11 is the common factor of numerator and denominator. So it is not in its simplest form. That's why we have to change into a simplified form. Okay? How we can simplify? Just we are dividing numerator and denominator by the same number, that is 11. 11, 1 is 11. And 3, 33, it is 3, bring down 33. 11, 3 is 0. Okay? 11, 1 is 11 and 0. Okay? So 13 by 10. Also, we know that 13 by this 10 we can write as 2 into 5. 2 into 5 means 2 to the power of 1 and 5 to the power of 1. Okay? That is, the denominator is in the form of 2 to the power of n, 5 to the power of m. That's why this fractional number gives terminating decimal. Terminating decimal. That means, for this also, this is the answer. It gives terminating decimal. Okay? Thank you.